हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, फॉर द सेवेंथ स्टैंडर्ड फिजिक्स टुडे आई विल बी एक्सप्लेनिंग लेसन हीट. नाउ इन दिस लेसन यू आर गोइंग टू लर्न अबाउट इंट्रोडक्शन टू हीट, डिफरेंट यूनिट्स ऑफ टेम्परेचर एंड इफेक्ट्स ऑफ हीट इन एवरीडे लाइफ. अंडर दिस आई विल बी टेकिंग जस्ट वन और टू एग्जाम्पल्स. राइट, नाउ हीट एज यू ऑल नो इज अ फॉर्म ऑफ एनर्जी. Right, and sun is the major source of energy from where we get heat. Apart from light, sun also gives us heat, and there are various other sources of heat as well. Like from a candle we get heat, from a bulb also we get heat. So another thing about heat is that it can flow from one object to another object, and it is observed that heat always flows from a higher object to an object having more energy to an object having less energy. Like for example, if you have hot water which is kept in a glass, and you just keep the glass on the table, so after some time you'll find that hot water will become cold. Now here what has happened, all the heat energy that was present in the glass is being lost to the environment, so eventually the water becomes cold. So that means this heat, two objects which are in contact will transfer heat from one object to another object, and it always flows from a higher object to a lower object. Right, so next now I'm going to tell you all about different units of heat. Now usually heat is measured in joules. The other units of heat are calories and kilocalories. Like if you look at any packet, like food packet, in fact if you look at this content given in there, you'll find that energy content will be given, mentioned over there, like and that will be usually in calories or at times in kilocalories. That means after consuming that food packet, how much of energy you are going to get, that is being specified in the food packet. Right, next we talk about temperature, different units of temperature. What is temperature? And the different scales which are used to measure temperature. Right? Now, temperature is nothing but the degree of hotness or coldness of a body. That means temperature measures how hot an object is or how cold an object is. Now, the instrument that is used to measure temperature is a thermometer. Now, and the SI unit of temperature is Kelvin, and the most preferred units are you have the Celsius scale and you have the Fahrenheit scale. Now, I'm going to tell you all about the relation between Kelvin, Fahrenheit, and Celsius. So, how they are related, and then we'll see what are the scales. Now, Celsius scale, in fact you find there will be 100 degrees present. So we consider the freezing point of ice or the freezing point of water or melting point of ice as 0 degrees Celsius and boiling point of water as 100 degrees Celsius. So whenever you are calibrating a scale on the thermometer, if you have a thermometer, the moment you dip it in water which is about to freeze, the lower mark of the mercury level will show certain reading. So that has to be taken as 0 degree Celsius. And the same thermometer, when you dip it in boiling water which is kept for boiling, the moment it starts boiling, just note down the temperature. So that is the upper limit of the temperature, the thermometer, which is 100 degree Celsius. So that scale between 0 degree Celsius to 100 degree Celsius is divided into 100 equal parts. So each part is 1 degree Celsius. So this is how it is being calibrated. Now, 0 degree Celsius on the scale, it corresponds to 32 degree Fahrenheit. Right? So on the Fahrenheit, now we talk about the Fahrenheit scale. So 0 degree Celsius corresponds to 32 degree Fahrenheit. And the upper limit in case of a Fahrenheit scale is 212 Fahrenheit. That means on the Fahrenheit scale, boiling point of water is 212 degree Fahrenheit. Now between this, there will be 180 divisions present. So if you subtract 32 from 212, you get around 180. So there are 180 equal divisions present on the Fahrenheit scale. So each one, so there'll be 180 parts. So each part will represent 1 degree Fahrenheit. And then you have the Kelvin scale. Now, in case of Kelvin scale, 0 degree corresponds to 273 Kelvin. 0 degree Celsius corresponds to 273 Kelvin. And the upper limit is 100 degree Celsius, which is the boiling point of water. It corresponds to 373 Kelvin. Right? And the minimum level, now 0 Kelvin corresponds to minus 273 degree Celsius. Now this 0 Kelvin is called as absolute zero, where life stops. In fact, life stops. There is no movement of the molecules. No molecules will move. So it is considered as absolute zero. Alright. Now we come to the relation between Celsius, Fahrenheit, and Kelvin. Now, if you check on if you want to convert from Celsius to Fahrenheit, any value given in Celsius, 9/5 multiplied by whatever value is given in Celsius, when you add 32 to it, you get a value in terms of Fahrenheit, right? Then if there's a value which is given in terms of Fahrenheit and you want to convert it in terms of Celsius, then you have 5/9 into F minus 32. So whatever value you get, you have to substitute a value of Fahrenheit in there and multiplied by 5/9 and divided by 9. So you get a value in terms of degree Celsius, right? And Kelvin is whatever, suppose you have a value in terms of degree Celsius, you just have to add 273 to the given value in Celsius to convert it in terms of Kelvin. Okay, so this was about temperature conversion. There'll be another video where there will be numericals, solved numericals will be shown. Now, how is heat and temperature different? What is the difference between heat and temperature? Now, heat is a form of energy, whereas temperature is the degree of hotness or coldness of an object, of a body. Now, unit of heat is joules or calories and kilocalories, whereas unit of temperature is, you can, SI unit is Kelvin. And other most preferred other units will be Celsius and Fahrenheit, right? And heat is a form of energy which cannot be measured in fact. But temperature, we use an instrument which is a thermometer to measure the temperature, right? Next, I'll talk about effects of heat in everyday life. Okay. Now, sun being the major source, as I've already said, there are other sources of heat as well. Now, what are the effects of heat? On application of heat, what can happen to an object? Now, an object can change its state, like for example, from one state to another on application of heat. on a second thing, on application of heat, its temperature can change. On application of heat, it can be used to create fire, right? And another thing is, it can change the shape and size of an object. Now here I'll be explaining about, now I'm going to explain about catching fire, right? So on application of heat, like for example, you have a paper. The moment you heat it, you apply heat energy, you supply it with heat energy, you find the paper starts burning, isn't it? If you use a magnifying glass and try to concentrate sun's rays at one particular place, you can heat that object and eventually that object can catch fire. So that means heat is being used to catch, in catching fire. Now remember, based on how fast an object can catch fire, whether an object can catch fire or it cannot catch fire, depending on that, objects or materials can be termed as flammable or inflammable objects. Now what are flammable objects? Objects which can catch fire, like paper, wood, dry leaves. These are examples of flammable objects. And inflammable objects are those objects which cannot catch fire. Like for example, stones, iron, some of the metals, okay, which have a very high melting point. So these are some of the examples of inflammable objects. Now when we talk about flammable objects, now there are certain objects which will catch fire easily. Now what is the condition for those objects to catch fire? Now it has to reach a definite temperature for like for example, when you bring a piece of paper close to a candle flame, you find immediately the paper will catch fire. So that means its ignition temperature is quite low. But if you take a piece of wood and keep it close, bring it close to a candle flame, you find it will take some time to catch fire. That means it has to reach its ignition temperature. Only then you find the object will catch fire. Now there are certain gases also which are highly flammable, like liquids also, like for example petrol, diesel, gases in the form of hydrogen, which catches fire. So they have which catch fire very quickly, so they have a very low ignition temperature. So depending on the ignition temperature, this ignition temperature will in fact decide how fast an object can catch fire. Alright. Next is change in temperature. Now when on application of heat, there can be change in temperature. Now if you look at a molecular level, now matter is made up of molecules. So when heat is being applied, you find that this heat energy is used to move the molecules or atoms which are present in a substance apart. So when they go apart, you find there'll be a change, the motion of the molecules increases, right? So when they go apart, that means they are on the verge of changing its state. So that is the time when you find the due to the motion of the molecules, you find there'll be a change in temperature. Alright, now this part, that is change of state, I'll be explaining in the next video. Alright, so far I've explained about under effects of heat in everyday life. I've explained about catching fire as to how heat is responsible in catching fire of any object, and I've also explained about change in temperature. So in the next class, you'll be learn about change of state and change in shape and size of an object on application of heat. All right. Thank you.